In this episode of The Engineer's Kitchen, we want to talk about the smart historian. But what is it that we need to consider to perform a smart historian? Emilian, do you have an idea?
Of course. Thank you for the invitation. Nice coffee, nice atmosphere. Thank you. Let's see first, I propose you to have a look to a report. It's coming from Zenon Analyzer. And as you can see here, we have plenty of information what the production teams can use to optimize their production, their performance. And if you look from another point of view, from technical point of view, we can see here information coming from different sources, processed information, aggregated information, structured information, key performance indicators. So what is behind of this? This is what I would like a bit to highlight today.
Great.
And yeah, of course, we can start with the first step, which is actually the data collection. Data collection, data acquisition. I propose you to have a look for this in the Zenon editor development environment. So from this point of view, we have plenty of possibilities in Zenon, and one of them is to get data over different drivers. As we know, we have here over 300 communication protocols. Not only over the drivers, we can get the data in Zenon. We can use the process gateway, APIs, and many other ways to bring the data here in Zenon.
So you mean this is the very first, very important step we need to collect the data from? Wherever it
originates. Well, of course, different sources, doesn't matter which machine, which PLC, we can bring everything together in one system. And then we have here a list of tags. And what is interesting, already in this phase, you can contextualize the data.
Okay.
So to make clear where the data is coming from, and for this purpose, we have in Zenon equipment modeling. Actually, we can describe here an asset model. And you can see, you can do it like in ISA 95, for instance, to describe all the structure. And this structure and this contextualization you can use in your project everywhere to put here everything you may need, many components, many elements.
So this is a very first step to give a data point, a single piece of information, some context. So to know where it is, to know what it is, whatever
exactly.
the meaning is.
Where it's coming from, you can even introduce your media models. So it's not just asset model. You are free to be a bit creative here, depending to your application.
Great, great. So you can also share these models or make many of them. So it depends on the view you want to take on your data. According to that, you can define then your models and your context.
Exactly, exactly. So slowly, the data is getting to be an information. It's getting to have a meaning and a context. The next step is what we do with the data. And we have here a powerful tool. We have, in fact, different possibilities to process the data in real time. And the one I like very much is Zenon Logic, integrated fully in Zenon Supervisor. And here you can see you can use different kind of programs and languages to process the data, to prepare, for instance, some counters, to process the data before you archive it.
Okay. So also maybe with the goal to reduce the data amounts in the historian, then finally, so I have kind of average values or whatever you can do with that.
This is true. This is one of the possibilities. So you can maybe correct some errors in real time before you really bring the data in the archive. One more step is to create and enable alarms, for instance, and events. So just getting from tags to alarms and events. So this is a further piece of information. And this you bring again in the contextualization. I switch now to our Zenon runtime. And here in the Zenon runtime, we have an overview of the plant, and we can have a view of all the alarms coming from everywhere. We already see here some results of such processing, like indicators. But if we speak about contextualization here, we simply can filter in the same way, and we will filter just the alarms of the filler. So this contextualization brings already advantages at the Zenon supervisor level.
Are there any other options for contextualization in the runtime system, or is it this equipment model we've seen?
Yes, we can see some other levels of contextualization. One of them we can just mention here is the shift contextualization. It's a time-based contextualization. And we will see that even the next step of our information flow, we have still possibilities in this.
Okay, great. Looking forward to it.
So if I switch now back to the zenon development environment, we are able to speak about historization. And the central module for this, it's our historian. And yeah, I just select a project which is maybe more relevant. You can choose always which tags you want to historize, you want to archive. You can create as many archives as you want. You can configure them, how they should work. And you can define actually the behavior of your archiving, and you can make it to be perfectly adapted to your process. How often you want to archive, when, triggered by events and so on. Regarding the contextualization, here it's an important point. You can contextualize the values according to the lot, to the production lot. For instance, if you have a batch production, you can follow completely the batch step by step and use this information afterwards for your analysis on this batch. So very much in direction of traceability, quality reporting, and so on and so forth. From the archiving point of view, again, you can scale. You can have the binary archiving, which is a local archiving in principle, but you have the possibility to scale it, to bring it down to SQL and even to Azure. What I like very much in this mechanism, you have a buffering mechanism. So in case that you don't have an availability of this server, you still buffer the data, you don't lose anything.
So SQL is a very good keyword. We've seen a lot of things that you can generate, contextualize, and generate kind of metadata. Is there, let's say, a single point of source where I can combine this everything, bring it together, and for further processing? How could I progress with all this information?
It's a good point because we have seen different separate possibilities, but at the end, actually, you get in one database, in one SQL database, very complete representation of the reality from the modeling point of view, from the context point of view, and so you bring in this context data series, alarms, events, and everything you may need for further analysis. Then you can filter on it, you can aggregate it further, and do whatever you want. And this can be done by different applications. And Zenon, it's Zenon Analyzer, actually, it's a good example how we profited maximum from this kind of structure, as I have shown you at the beginning.
Emilian, great. Really, very great insight into the possibilities or the strategies you need to consider for a smart historian. Let me present you one of our Engineer's Kitchen t-shirts as a small thank you.
Thank you very much. Thank you.
And thanks for joining this episode of Engineer's Kitchen. What a delicious episode of COPA-DATA's Engineer's Kitchen. If you are still hungry, please subscribe to our YouTube channel.